Oh, hey there. Welcome back. Today, we're going to be looking at three-channel reading. What it is, how you do it, and why it's a useful activity for your language learning. Let's start with the name, since it's actually pretty helpful for understanding the fundamentals of this activity. The first part of it, three-channel, refers to the different channels of input you have. Listening, reading, and visual context. This is most common in things like TV shows, movies, or YouTube, because you can hear what the characters are saying, read along with the subtitles, and see what they're doing visually. The second part of the name, reading, refers to the easiest part of the activity. In our experience, the main skill that you improve during a language learning activity is the easiest, or the lowest common denominator. And since reading is easier than listening, you're primarily working on your reading skills, even though you are both reading and listening, but we call it reading because that's the easier of those two skills, the one that you're actually improving. And technically, anything with three channels and reading is three-channel reading. But today, we're going to be looking specifically at three-channel intensive reading. And that word intensive just means that you're going slowly, looking things up, and verifying that you do understand what you're immersing in. Toward the beginning of your language learning journey, this is one of the best ways to push your abilities forward while having the most fun possible. Yes, you do go slow, but you understand a lot more of harder content, so it's more interesting. And the three channels give you plenty of ways to understand the language, since you're reading and you can also listen and you can see what's going on. And since it's an intensive activity, it's really helping you solidify and expand your abilities in the language. In order to do three-channel reading, you actually don't need much. All you need is a piece of visual media with subtitles, some sort of dictionary, I'll be using Vocab Civ in this example, and a meta layer, I'll be using ASV Player. Technically, this part is optional, but it makes the process way easier. And then there's one more optional thing, which is a way to save interesting words or sentences. You can use a notepad program, physical note cards, or whatever you'd like. And you can do three-channel intensive reading at any level in the process. But it's most useful when you already know 500 to 1,000 of the most common words of the language. If you're still learning the absolute basics, there's just going to be too much stuff that you don't know and it will be overwhelming. If you're still learning the basics, I recommend that you just simply play the noticing game. Actually doing three-channel intensive reading is very easy. I recommend you turn on auto pause, which is why I'm using ASB Player, and I'll do Control P for that. And now, for each line, here's the general loop. Listen and read along. Look at the sentence and try to understand it. And if you do, that's great. Press play and continue. But if you don't, check the number of words you don't know. If it's more than two unknown words, make your best guess on the sentence and then move on. But if you're only missing one or two of those words, look them up. With that new information, you should be able to understand the sentence and be able to move on with the show. If you know all the words, or you don't understand after looking up all of them, then there's some grammar happening in the sentence. If you can, try to make a guess on what the sentence means, and then you can look at the sentence in a translator or look up a piece of grammar. If your guess on the sentence was correct or close, look at the sentence again and ask yourself why it took you a second to figure it out. But if the sentence is totally wild and you have no idea why it means that, just move on for now. Oh, and if at any point in this process that you think a sentence is useful or interesting and you want to save it for later, that's when you put it into your text file or notepad or whatever it is. In the demonstration, I just copy things into a text file. And that's three-channel intensive reading. That's really it. Something you might have found a little bit weird is the times when I said to move on with a sentence before you actually understood it. When a sentence includes too many unknown words or there's something that's just too complex for you to process, it's not really worth your time to decipher them. As you get better with the language, those nearly impossible sentences become so much easier and simpler, and that's when you should be learning them. Ideally, throughout the entire language learning process, you're doing things that are always just a little bit too hard for you or a little bit outside your comfort zone. You expand your knowledge little by little. And trying to go for something that's just way out there or super complicated just isn't as efficient and can be kind of frustrating. Now, let's see what three-channel intensive reading looks like in action. I have a clip here of me doing it in Czech, and I'm going to actually narrate over what I was doing while I was studying because I was silent then. Okay, let's watch me do three-channel reading while I talk about what's happening. So, this is the end of the scene. And so here, I'm just listening to the sentence and then reading it, and then I go and I click on the words that I don't quite understand. So in this case, that word I didn't really know, and this other one was the only other one I didn't know in the sentence. So I looked them both up, and then I tried listening again, One of them didn't look up, so I actually didn't try to go further to it, but you often don't have to spend too much time on words because you should kind of just keep moving on with your reading. And then if I go back, I was able to then understand that sentence fully. Even though I didn't get that full word, I didn't really need to because it's everything else is there, and it's sort of clear what they're doing. And then we have another sentence here where again, I sort of go over it, I check it, and then I click on a word that I maybe don't know or recognize fully. And so in this case, it was something to reach or to finish off. And then once I do that, then I kind of look at the whole sentence here. This is me kind of analyzing it and processing it and going, okay, so what does it mean? I know all the words, so da-da-da-da-da-da-da, and then I figure it out. You should like to listen to it again once more just because to process it, and then I keep going. And then again here, that's that same word, but I already sort of didn't really remember exactly what it was, and so I check it again. It was very similar to that one in another sentence, but so I look it up and then we continue on. Here again, it's sort of a key word. I got everything else in the sentence, but there's one main thing that is just unsure, so I look it up. When I look it up, I see it's what it means to shoot, and then I'm able to understand the whole sentence, so I moved on very quickly because it was very easy to understand. Same thing here, just one word missing. So I look it up, or two rather, and then I move on right away. I try to keep things moving so that this doesn't take too much longer. This whole scene only lasts like 30 seconds in real time, but it took me about 2 minutes to do. Then we see something starts happening. I'm just going through because this is pretty clear what they mean. I did want to go back and look up. I'm nearly positive what that word means, but I had a thing in the back of my head that was like, oh, you should go look up that word. So I went and tried it. It didn't even work. And then here in this case, I do recognize this word, but I go, oh, actually, that'd be a nice thing to say. That's a nice, useful sentence. And so I just copy and paste it into a notepad. That's all I do for this. And then, yeah, we're basically done with the scene now. Not really a whole lot going on, not really a lot of talking, but that's generally what you do. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this demo of three-channel reading. If you're struggling to make progress with your language and you haven't done this before, I highly recommend that you try it out. And then let us know down in the comments, how did it go? Did you learn anything interesting? Was this easier or harder than you expected? I genuinely do look forward to reading your comments and seeing your responses, so please don't be shy. Oh, and make sure that you're subscribed so that you can see the next video. And I'll see you then. Happy immersing. I'm here to drop some knowledge. Listen up with your ears. I got a language learning method. Gonna make it crystal clear. Call Refold the game changer. Gonna blow your mind. Immerse yourself in media. Fluency you will find. Refold.